Hi, welcome to Fat Burning Yoga. I'm Sarah Ivanhoe. I've created this energized and movement-oriented yoga program to burn calories, increase flexibility, and give your body that strong, lean, and fit look. The routine is safe, it's easy to follow, and fun. My philosophy is that if it isn't fun, you won't do it. And the only way to burn fat is to do it, and do it, and do it. Here's some tips before starting. Always practice on a non-slip surface in your bare feet. Wear comfortable workout clothes. As with any fitness program, practice at your own pace. And lastly, be aware of your breathing. The breathing in yoga goes both in and out through your nose, creating a soft, hollow sound. The quality of your breath directly affects your movement, so keeping the flow of breath smooth and even is a priority. Before we get started, I want to introduce you to my friend Natasha. She'll be doing modifications of the sequence. So if you need a little easier routine, you just follow her. So we're going to start in mountain pose. Your feet are hips width apart and parallel. Your low belly goes in and your tailbone drops down. The chest lifts up while the shoulders stay relaxed. Take a nice deep breath in. And as you exhale, bring the palms together at your heart. Sweep the arms up as you inhale. And then sweep them down as you exhale. Real simple, just to get you breathing and moving. Inhale, sweep the arms up, press the palms together, and exhale, release the hands down. As you sweep the arms up, keep that low belly in and the tailbone down. Exhale, release them. Sweep the arms up as you inhale, look up at your hands and stretch. Exhale, release the hands down. Last one, sweep the arms up, big breath in, exhale, palms come together at your heart. Now we're adding on. Sweep the arms up as you inhale, and then we're gonna fold forward all the way down. Again, for an easier version, keep your eyes on Natasha. Halfway up, look forward, pull your chest forward. On the exhale, top of the head towards the floor. Arms out to the sides, lead with the chest, come all the way up. Look up at your hands, and then exhale, release the palms together. We're gonna do four more just like that. Sweep the arms up, inhaling, and exhale, hinge at the hips, swan dive fold. Look forward, stretch the chest forward on the inhale. Exhale, fold deeply, arms out to the sides. As you come up, the belly goes in, tailbone down. Exhale, release. Lots of breath through the nose, inhaling and exhaling. Inhale, offering the heart. Exhale, bow the head all the way up. Inhale, exhale. This is the last one, so really make it count. Big breath in. Remember, this breath is going to get your blood oxygenated, getting the blood moving is the best way to burn those calories. All the way up, look up at the hands, and exhale. And from here, interlace your fingers behind your back. Take a big lift into the chest, and then hinge at the hips, fold forward, take the hands towards the floor in front of you. Now, even though I'm pretty flexible here, I still like to keep a nice deep bend in my knees. It just feels nicer on my back. Keep breathing. And then just turn your head from side to side a couple times so that you know your head and neck is relaxed. From here, bend your knees a lot. Sit your hips down to the floor. Unhook your hands, circle them forward and up, and come into the chair pose. Now, all of us here are doing our best to sit down deeply to get our thighs parallel to the floor. But you just work at your own pace. Your belly stays in to support your low back. And then press down through your heels to come all the way up to standing and release the hands. We're gonna put those movements together into a flowing series. Again, main thing is breath, okay? Interlace your fingers behind your back. Inhale, you lift the chest. Exhale, fold forward. Bend your knees, drop your hips, circle the arms up as you inhale. Exhale, up to standing, keep exhaling as you interlace the fingers behind you. Inhale, you lift. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, drop your butt, circle the arms up. Inhale to chair pose. Exhale up to standing and bring the hands behind you. Inhale, clear out your lungs and exhale, fold, bend your knees, circle the arms up. Inhale into those fingertips. Exhale up to standing. This is the last one. Inhale, you lift. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, circle the arms up. Inhale, chair pose. All the way up to standing this time. Bring the hands to your hips. Take a nice big inhale into the chest. And as you exhale, fold forward. Place your hands on the floor, shoulders distance apart, and step your feet back 4 to 5 feet, taking your hips up to the ceiling. This is what we call the downward facing dog position. And I know that's sort of a funny name, but a lot of poses in yoga are named after animals. So here in Downward Dog, take a couple of really deep breaths. Now we're gonna start our series of lunges. And the way we begin is by stepping the right foot all the way up to the hands and bringing your left knee to the floor. If the right foot didn't make it right away, just grab onto it and give it a nice graceful clunk forward. Sink your hips forward and down, and then place both hands onto the front thigh and take your chest up. Either stay here or circle your arms up, palms pressed together and look up. The idea is that the arms reach the body up off the floor so you get tall, but sit down a little deeper. Take a nice deep breath in, and then as you exhale, release the hands down to the floor and step back to downward facing dog. We're gonna go right to the other side. So step the left foot up to your hand, right knee to the floor. And if your knee is sensitive, feel free to put a towel or a cushion under it. Put both hands onto the front thigh and then circle your arms up. One nice trick that my friend Natasha here taught me is that if you take the front heel and you kick the floor down and away, not only does it strengthen the muscles in your legs, but it helps the low belly to go in and therefore stabilize the low back. So look up at your hands, take a big inhale, and on the exhale, hands to the floor and step back to plank pose, top of a push-up position. So in plank pose, your body is in a straight line. Your belly goes up, your thighs go up, but your tailbone goes down. Take a deep breath in, and then exhale, lower yourself to the floor. Uncurl your toes, push the tops of the feet down, and take your tailbone down. Start to bring your head and your chest up, and for this first back bend, don't use your hands. Just use the muscles in your back so they start to get warm. Drop the chin down slightly so the neck is relaxed. Take a deep breath in, and exhale, release the body down. Hands under the shoulders, curl your toes under, and press back to downward facing dog. This is a pose we do a lot, so you want to start getting used to it. Now we're going to repeat the same lunges, but a little bit faster this time. Okay, so start by taking the right foot up to your hands, left knee to the floor, sink the hips down, circle the arms up. Take a big breath in, look up, palms press. Exhale, release your hands down, stepping back to downward facing dog. Right away, side two, left foot steps to your hands, right knee to the floor, circle the arms up and reach. Exhale, hands to the floor, step back to plank pose, top of a push-up position. In plank pose, when we lower the body down, we want to keep the elbows hugged in. So as we lower, slowly lower down elbows, hug in tightly all the way down. Uncurl your toes, and then this time we're gonna come halfway up in the back bend. So halfway up, keep your elbows hugged in, your shoulders shrugged back,